In this lesson, we will look at a number line for tenths of a decimal. The number line model is more abstract than the region model that we used for decimals in lesson one. But this lesson will show how students can use the region model to develop the number line with understanding. This blank decimal number line can be reproduced for students. Students will notice that it has four whole numbers, 0, 1.0, 2.0, 3, and there are 10 spaces between each pair of numbers. Let's place the decimal square for 0.3 above the number line so that the shading begins above the 0 point. Students know the decimal for this square is 0.3, and this helps to show where 0.3 is written on the number line. Without making this connection from the area model to the number line, students often incorrectly will count the max on the number line starting at 0, 1, 2, 3, and think 0.3 should be written at the end of the third mach. A few more squares can be selected. Let's just illustrate the location for 0.9. We'll start the shading at 0. Now in this case, students know that the decimal for this square is 0.9, and so that tells us that 0.9 goes at this point. Students can fill in the rest of the decimal points from 0 to 1 or use the shaded amounts of squares as needed. Here we see the decimals for tenths written in between 0 and 1.0. 1.0 on this number line can be illustrated by placing one whole shaded square on the number line to represent one whole. This will be helpful to students who see the pattern 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, and so forth, 0.8, 0.9, and think the next decimal here for this point should be 0.10 or 0.10. To show that the decimal for this point is not 0.10, we can use the green shaded square with one column shaded. And students know the decimal for this square is 0.10, and the shading does not continue up to this point. So this square shows that the decimal for this point here, in addition to being 0.1, could be called 0.10. Now one use of the number line is measuring length. So we'll line up a paper clip here, starting at the 0 point. The length of this paper clip is more than 0.2 units and less than 0.3 units, but closer to 0.3 units. So the length of the paper clip, rounded to the nearest tenth, is 0.3 units. Some objects are too long to measure from 0 to 1.0. For example, the length of this pen has a length greater than 1.0. So we will extend the tenths from 1.0 to 2.0. Let's place the decimal square for 0.4 above the line so that its shading starts at the at 1.0. Since we have a length of 1 from 0 to 1.0, and now we have four more tenths, we can write 1.4 beneath the mach at the end of the shading for 0.4. Number 1.4 is a mixture of the whole number 1 and the decimal 0.4, so it is called a mixed decimal. More squares can be used as needed to get the mixed decimals for tenths from 1.0 to 2.0 and from 2.0 to 3.0. Here's a number line completed with mixed decimals in tenths from 0 to 3.0. Now we can measure longer objects, such as the pen we looked at a few minutes ago. Now we can see that its length is more than 1.3, less than 1.4, it's closer to 1.3 than 1.4. So in this case, we'll round down and say the length of the pen to the nearest tenth is 1.3 units. Students can measure objects such as the length of a pencil or the dimensions of a desk or book or sheet of paper. In this lesson, we use the area model, decimal squares, to make sense when labeling points on a line. We use the number line to measure objects, more applications of decimals, and introduced rounding in a natural way. The pen we measured had a length greater than 1, and this provided a reason to extend the number line and to introduce mixed decimals. When math concepts, such as those used in these two lessons, namely decimals, number lines, rounding, mixed decimals, can be introduced in a natural way to answer questions and provide information, and students will have a better feeling for mathematics.